Yeah, hello, HSV Hookey here. I thought I'd show you what I've been doing. There's the system board. And what I've done is I've run a bunch of switches to here, LEDs here, so I can do a test. It's like a little test bed, which I've been checking bits and pieces. That's the back side of that, and the front cover. Just had to do a wee repair on that. I'll get that one wired up. But what I wanted to show you, I'll turn around here, is here's the overhead, the aft part, and just put that in so that's fully wired. And these wires over the front are from that, and this one here's for the light behind there. As far as I'm aware. So hopefully the picture will be all going that way, this board, and this board down here will go that way, hopefully up and around and up, the way that it's in two bits there, so it fits into the sim. It's a bit dark, but up there, the system board's going to go up on my roof here, and come all the wiring will be up and come up and sit here. Everything will be there, and behind me the fuses, because these fuses work now. Well, it turns the power supplies on and off, but in behind there I'm going to put a couple of power supplies, maybe even one if it runs off it. And I'm going to use these 12 port hubs up here and run one USB back to the computer. Hopefully that works. But yeah, so that's my progress so far. I have been also doing other switches, which is the engine EEC. That one still sticks a bit. That one's okay. Yeah, I think that one just needs a bit more. Here's a real simple thing. T-shape. I got a mate of mine who I said, oh, I want to build a stand to hold the overhead, and he goes, mate, just use a T. A T-square sort of thing. I went, what? Within a few seconds, this basic, simple, yet very effective stand was made. Very easy. I'll go a bit slower, so. It's just screwed in here. Down the sides and on the front, just to protect it, is a little bit of sandpaper, actually, but thick sandpaper, but cardboard to the paint. But I'll touch up the paint if it's scratched. And yeah, I'll just run the system interface off my laptop at the moment. As you can see, I've only got that board, the 128-256, connected. Here's another oxygen crew. I've been cleaning the inside out because there was a bit of sawdust that had got into the flight illusion gauges. But how I cut it so I could remember which was what. And I will be showing other people how to do bits and pieces as well. Okay, awesome. Thanks for watching.